Can you see the screen, students?
No, ma'am.
Oh, it will take time.
No, now it's there.
Is everyone's to try to read whatever is given in the textbook, and if you don't understand, you have to ask me. Devratna, did you read it? Devratna? Devrat not there. Barbie. Barbie, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Did you read the chapter that nervous system, neural control and coordination?
Till the transmission of the impulses.
Acha, only that much. Okay. So I ear has been deleted from your syllabus, so we will not be doing that. So try to see today. Now put today's date, everyone, in your notebook and then write down the central nervous system and then write down structure of the brain. So today we will start with the structure of the brain. So everyone has studied in the first period we discussed that the central nervous system consists of the brain and the spinal cord. Brain and the spinal cord. Okay, and from that then you find arises the peripheral nervous system, which constitutes the nerves which are arising from the brain, known as the, what is it called, Raj? The nerves arising from the brain. Raj, can you tell me quickly?
I'm a spinal cord.
Nahi, nerves arising from the brain. What are they called? Spinal cord is running through this vertebral column, isn't it? Ye vertebral column bana hua hai, and through this neural canal of this, the spinal cord runs. Okay. So the nerves arise from the brain also, and the nerves arise from this long spinal cord also. So who will tell me quickly what are the nerves arising from the brain called?
Cranial nerves.
Cranial nerves. And what are the nerves arising from the spinal cord called?
Spinal nerves.
spinal nerve. Raj, remember. Okay, I have asked before also. Remember it. Okay, in the class, whatever we are discussing, try to learn it here itself. So it analyzes the sensory information received.
Your voice is not clear.
Voice is not clear. Okay. Others can hear?
Yes,
everyone,
ma'am.
It is going like that?
Ma'am, it flickers sometimes in the middle.
Okay. Also, then some network problem must be there. It carries out sensory, integrative, and motor functions. So now we'll take up functions of the brain. Everyone can note down what are the general functions of the brain. So it controls the important involuntary organs, that is heart and the lungs. Then it controls the voluntary movement. It balances the body. So keep noting these things. The sensation of hunger and thirst is controlled by the brain. Then regulates the body temperature, causes the body rhythm. Then regulates the production of body hormones. So you know that brain is having very important gland. What is that gland which is associated with the brain? Endocrine gland, any man?
Pituitary gland.
Yes, again, can you repeat it?
Pituitary gland.
Okay. And then one more gland is there, that is the pineal gland. So that way the pituitary gland is regulating the function of other glands. So we can say that brain is helping in production of body hormones. Then processes sensory memory impulses. And it is responsible for intelligence and behavior. Did you note down, everyone? So now, this will be a revision for you, and little more we will be adding to the knowledge what you have regarding this structure you have studied in 10th class. Okay, so now we'll take up. You all know that brain location. So everyone can note down again that brain is located in the bony brain box called cranium. Now, this brain is covered by the three membranous coverings, and we call it as meninges. You can see on the screen, children. Devanshi, can you see? So brain,
yes,
is covered by three membranous coverings. And what are these membranes called? The coverings called meninges. So what are these meninges? You can see here in the figure, they are showing the first one is the, that outermost will be the dura mater, then the pia mater, and the arachnoid. Most from outside we take dura mater. From pia mater,
ma'am, your voice is not clearly audible.
Okay, wait for your help. I'll note it down also. So the location, remember the brain is locations. First number, you should remember the location. Then it is protected by the location. All are knowing where is your brain located. Speak up, Rumisha, where is the brain located?
In bony brain box called cranium.
Cranium, okay. Now we are talking about the coverings. Okay, so what is the covering? The brain is protected by the membranous coverings, which are known as meninges. Meninges, and there are three meninges. What are they? They are dura mater, then second one is your pia mater. And the third one is arachnoid. So this we have discussed in 10th also. Remembering Barbie, Neha?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the covering. Now the space between the these meninges and the brain is filled by the fluid. Are you remembering what is that fluid called? Anyone?
Cerebrospinal fluid.
Very good. It is known as cerebrospinal fluid. So, the space between the brain and the meninges is protected by the filled by the cerebrospinal fluid. So what is the work of the cerebrospinal fluid? Are you all remembering? Prevents from
mechanical shocks.
Prevents from mechanical shocks. So now I'll take up the next slide. The brain is lodged in the skull, a bony cage. The spine is surrounded by the vertebral column, that is a series of the small bones. So these two things remember, matlab bony covering pure central nervous system ke upar hai. Okay, and the meninges of the brain is surrounded by the cerebral meninges, three-layered membrane. So you can note down, but not, you don't have to do it much in detail, but for the competitive exams, you will have to prepare. Okay, for the 11th class, I may not ask in detail, but for your competitive exams, you will have to prepare. So you can note down, the dura mater is the tough outer membrane, then arachnoid. So middle one is the arachnoid, and the innermost is the paramata. You can do the correction. Then middle layer of the cerebral meninges, and it is the inner. So the outermost is composed of fibrous connective tissue. The middle is also made up of the fibrous connective tissue. And the innermost is transparent and it adheres to the surface of the brain and the spinal cord. So this meninges is covering the whole of the central nervous system. These three layers are covering the whole of the central nervous system. Noted, everyone? Shall I take up the next slide? Neha, can you speak up?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, the structure of the brain. The brain is divided into three parts. So, what are the three parts? Can Raj tell me?
Can you repeat?
Raj, fast. What are the three parts of the brain? How we have divided the brain into?
Ma'am, forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain.
Yes. Your voice is very clear. Okay. What are the parts of the forebrain? Which parts of the brain are included in the forebrain? Can you tell me? Okay, Barbie will tell me quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Brain is divided into three parts: forebrain, middle brain, and hindbrain.
Okay. So forebrain, try to understand children and note down, the forebrain is also known as prosencephalon. We are doing the structure of the brain. So the brain structure divided into forebrain. Forebrain, the first part, then the midbrain, that is the middle part of the brain, and the posterior part of the brain is called the hindbrain. So forebrain is also known as the prosencephalon. Prosencephalon. So try to see in the LON, prosencephalon. Now you can see here this major part of the brain, which is your creamish color shown in the figure. This is the forebrain. So the forebrain consists of 2/3, that is cerebrum part. Okay, 2/3 of the total brain, you can see in this figure also, that 2/3 of the total brain is constituting, that is the cerebrum. Cerebrum is this whole part, and it is 2/3 of the total brain. This cerebrum, then the next part is the thalamus and the hypothalamus. So cerebrum I have explained in 10th class. Try to revise, try to recollect that this cerebrum is divided into two cerebral hemispheres by the deep longitudinal fissure. And the two cerebral hemispheres, they are remaining together, they remain intact. Beech mein deep fissure hone ke baad bhi wo dono separate nahi ho jate hain because of the sheet of nerves, which is known as corpus callosum. So both the parts, that is the two different parts of the cerebrum, we call it as the cerebral hemispheres. So cerebrum is divided into two cerebral hemispheres. Did you all note down, children? Yes or no? Speak up so that I can understand that you all are getting the things what I'm explaining.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
Cerebrum is divided into two cerebral hemispheres. Two cerebral hemispheres. Two cerebral hemispheres by deep longitudinal fissure. By deep longitudinal fissure. Deep longitudinal fissure. Now each of the cerebral hemisphere is further divided into four lobes. Four lobes. Each cerebral hemisphere is divided into four lobes. Now, what are those four lobes? You can write down the names, then we'll go in detail. Frontal, parietal, temporal. If this is not clear, I'll take it again. Okay, frontal, parietal, temporal, and occipital. The four lobes are there. Each cerebral hemisphere, left and right cerebral hemisphere, we call them, and each of the cerebral hemisphere is divided into four lobes by three wide fissures. Fissures, we are calling it the cut or the impression there, which is present. That is the fissure. जो cut, जो division होगा उसी को fissure बोल रहे हैं. तो एक deep fissure दो में divide कर देता है, फिर दो hemisphere को हर hemisphere में, फिर तीन wide fissures are there, which is dividing. Those three wide fissures are dividing the cerebral hemispheres into four lobes. So you find that these four lobes are present in left cerebral hemisphere also, as well as the right cerebral hemisphere. The next part is the thalamus, then hypothalamus. Now the other one, so we'll take it one by one. Now midbrain, you can name it, write down the names, corpora quadrigemina and crura cerebri. So these are the new words you have not done in 10. Note down now. And hindbrain, you can see this green color structure which is shown here. This whole green color part is the hindbrain, and this red color part is the midbrain. So midbrain consists of two parts, corpora quadrigemina and crura cerebri. And this green part, you find it has three parts, the cerebellum. So this part round, it is the cerebellum. There, this is the pons. Can you see my cursor? This is the pons. Speak up, someone, if you are listening.
Yes, ma'am.
And then this extension, can you see this part? A rod-like structure, it is the medulla oblongata. So the parts names you all have done. Now we'll take up the next. So cerebrum, it is occupied by the brain, the major part of the human brain, which we have discussed, divided into left and right cerebral hemispheres. Then collection of nerves called corpus callosum, they connect the two hemispheres, and they're discovered by the whitish myelin sheath. Okay, and this is referred to as the white matter. So you will find that the white matter in the case of the brain is outside or inside. Are you remembering what I told in 10th class? In the spinal cord topic, I explained. Butterfly shaped jo spinal cord na reflex arc, actually, jo reflex arc mein dekhte ho, that is your gray matter. And outside there is a white matter. The brain mein opposite hota hai. Okay, so which matter will be present? You can see here the highly folded layer called the cerebral cortex covers the hemispheres, and it has many nerve cell bodies that are gray and hence gray color. So it is called gray matter. This is very important, children. What is gray matter and what is white matter? Okay, why we call it white matter? Because उस region के nerve cells के ऊपर myelin sheath नहीं present है, so it will appear grey in color, so you call it grey matter. And some nerves have the myelin sheath, that is the nerve cells, and that's why it appears white in color, and we call that as the white matter. In the brain case, try to understand the white matter is. White matter is inside and the gray matter is outside. And in the spinal cord, gray matter is inside and it is in the shape of a butterfly, and white matter is outside. The areas in the cortex are of three types based on the functions: motor, sensory, association areas. Now we'll try to see the next one. So what are the functions of the cerebrum? Involved in sensory, motor and integrative functions, they are largely carried out by the cerebral cortex. They're involved in the analysis of sensory input from the receptors present all over the body. remember the vision, touch, smell, hearing, taste is all done by the four different lobes of the cerebral cortex, or the cerebral hemisphere. Then involved in the control of muscular movements and glandular secretion. Then Barbie, read out the fourth one. What is given? Yes, Barbie. Are you there, Barbie?
Yes, ma'am.
So you are where? You are run away or what?
No, I think some network connection on my phone is. I don't know.
Okay, Rumisha, can you read it quickly?
Yes, ma'am. Responsible for integrative functions like emotional responses, moral behavior, learning, memory, reasoning, judgment, awareness, and intelligence, etc.
Okay. So this way, there are different functions are performed by the four different lobes. Now we take up the other part, that is the thalamus. So what is the thalamus part? Try to see here. It is the oval structure present just below the center. This hole is green color. This is the skin color structure in the center. And below it, this part over it.
Ma'am, your voice is not clear.
Okay, I'm just repeating. Try to see the figures. See my cursor. This upper part is the whole cerebrum. And this label, the small structure is the thalamus. And thalamus, what is what? It coordinates for the, it is a coordinating center for sensory motor signaling. So you can note down the function. Then, उसके नीचे की जो part है, उसको अपन hypothalamus बोल रहे हैं. So it is located below the thalamus. अभी बताते हैं, an hypothalamus we have studied in that endocrine system chapter that it is neurosecretory. It has got neurosecretory cells. It secretes the hormone. Now, thalamus, you can note down, it regulates body temperature and is responsible for sensations of hunger and thirst. Sensations of hunger and thirst. Note it all of all. Devratna? Yeah, so we'll take up the next part. The limbic system we'll discuss next video. So try to read the brain structure what is given in the textbook. I'm stopping the sharing. Tell me whatever structure we have discussed, you have followed or not. We have completed with the four way.
Yes, ma'am.
Only the four way we have discussed. Did you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Barbie.
Yes, ma'am.
Devratna.
Yes, ma'am.
I couldn't hear your voice in the middle of the class. Why? Are you there or not?
And there was some network issue, so I could not join the class.
The network. Okay. Okay. Last period mein bhi bahut gadbad ho raha tha na, Devratna?
Yes, ma'am.
It was connecting, then again you were leaving, then connecting, again leaving. Okay. So now what you all do, everyone, the homework is you will finish up the one experiment That is experiment number one from the section B, and from the your experiment number two, you will draw only bacteria diagram. And I told you how to do the work. So just do one organism, show it to me, and then I will be telling you all to do the other diagrams. Okay. And then section A, so everyone has completed. Jo nahi hua hai, to try to finish up that. And then we will continue with the structure of the brain next period.